Hey, what's up, garden friends? Say hi, Toby.
Jeff here, Tropical Plant Party.
How's everybody doing?
I hope you're good. I am great. You good boy, Tuck.
Doing a very last minute garden tour-ish. If you watched my most recent vlog, then you know that I'm not here right now. I'm filming this. I'm going to be getting on a plane here very shortly. It's been a busy day trying to get things planted and in the ground, and I am going to attempt to do this all in one take without editing, so we'll see how that goes.
Because I'm going on vacation. I don't really want to edit a long video while I'm on vacation.
Screaming children, that could be trouble with editing. Maybe you guys, it's okay. It's not a big deal. Typically, I do a May, June, July, August, September, October garden tour. This year, I haven't been able to do that, and that's because there have been some issues with my irrigation. Supposedly, there's maybe a leak. They put some dye in the ground, didn't find it, but because of that, I didn't want to plant anything, because then wherever the leak is, I'm going to have to rip up whatever I plant. So there have just been plants all over my patio, down here, over here, particularly a lot over there by the table where I was doing a lot of my repotting. I just finished up the vlog, the most recent video from this one, where I went out and planted a bunch of things in my front yard and repotted a bunch of things. That was actually from 2 weeks ago. But anyways, I wanted to put something out to be able to see a contrast between June and July. So I thought, go ahead and do that now. A minute and a half into the video. Start looking at plants. Over here, these are the colocasias bikini teenies, and they are taking over with a vengeance like they do. Normally every year I put sun impatiens in here. I do, like, I alternate colors. I have them here. I have the deep rose, the coral pink, neon pink, and then these, what are these? The compact hot coral. I haven't had time to get them in the ground yet, so for now, since I'm going to be gone, I'm moving these over where my sprinklers will be hitting them. A lot of what's going to be in this video is me having moved things where the sprinklers will hit them so that the people who are house-sitting won't have to water the plants. Oh, and just like to throw it out there, I'm filming this before I leave. By the time it comes out, I will be home, so don't like break into my house or anything like that. I think it's kind of dangerous announcing to the world when you're not going to be home. So just putting that out there. Here are the planters I did a few vlogs ago. The mule palms, where I repotted these, put these Super Tunia bubblegum vistas in here with these Sweet Caroline lime sweet potato vines. The two on this end of the pool, right here and right here, got potted up just a week after I did the queen palms, which are down here. And look at what a difference 1 week makes. Isn't that incredible? These have really filled out. I expect the other ones that I just showed down there, the mule palms, they should be filled out just as well too, very shortly, especially since I have them set up on drip right now. Since I'm going to be gone, that's going to make a big difference in their growth too. The drip, you put things on drip and they just grow like crazy. Yeah, look at how nice and full these are getting. I am really pleased with these sweet potato vines. Last year, the ones I put in were just way too big. These may end up doing the same thing. I tried one of these last year and it wasn't as vigorous, but these are looking like they're going to be pretty vigorous. So I'm going to have to wait and see, but I can control it. It's not a big deal. But I am really liking the way these Super Tunia Vista bubblegums look. They're already very full, really happy. Those will be spilling down the sides of these pots. I bet for the July garden tour, which from the time this video comes out will be like 3 weeks from now, maybe four, this will be at least double the size, at least. Over here are the palm planters that I put together in a video several weeks ago. They're extra full right now because any annuals I haven't had time to plant, I'm sticking them wherever my micro irrigation, my drips are going to hit them. So that's why there's like random things sitting around in these pots. But these Super Tunias haven't taken off as much, but there's not quite as much sun over here either, which shouldn't be an issue for the Vista bubblegum. I've grown those in shade before and they still flowered, but their growth was a little bit more spindly, not quite as pretty, but they still flowered a bunch. It was just longer, lankier growth, but it was nice to have flowers in the shade, at least petunias in the shade, I mean. And everything back here was in the vlog from 2 weeks ago, and that like was just filmed very recently, so there's no changes there, really. This succulent planter, I did this one, I don't know, maybe a month ago, and everything in here is doing great. The Senecio's really taken off. This aeonium that's in the center is doing really, really well. It's growing much faster than I thought. The growth is nice and stiff and strong.
not too long, and those should be coming up, and sorry, my hand's a little wobbly. Those should be coming up and above everything a little bit further. That's going to look really cool. But I love how well this has filled out. It's doing really well. I haven't touched this. It's been about 3 weeks under my umbrella because it rained nonstop, and I think I have watered this maybe one time. That's probably about it. I haven't needed to, one, because we've had a bunch of rain, and, you know, the succulents, they don't need a ton of water. And yeah, like with these, there aren't a ton of updates to give because it literally, like, just did those, basically. But they're looking pretty. I'm excited to be gone for a week. That's one of the fun things about a vacation is you're gone, you come home, and you get to see all the changes with everything, and that's a lot of fun. Got a fresh new leaf opening up here on the Bird of Paradise. A little bit of storm damage on it. This one opened up, like, right after I planted it. This Bird of Paradise right here, this one, so much more vigorous than that one. And I don't think it's a light thing. I think it's just, I don't know, actually. Maybe this one is more root-bound. I repotted this one over here last year, so that probably has something to do with it. They like to be a little bit root-bound. But it's throwing up a new leaf here, has another one back here. It's very happy. The other one's happy too. It's just not growing quite as much, but it has a new leaf coming up right over there, right there. So that's good. These alocasias that I took from divisions are starting to finally do their thing. It's been about probably 2.5 weeks, and they didn't have a ton of roots on them when I put them in here since I divided them up and off of a bigger plant. But once I do a transplant with alocasias and they throw out their first leaf, that's usually when I'm like, okay, you're good. I don't have to worry about you anymore. So that's a great sign. Same thing with the ginger I divided up that's back here. It's starting to throw out new growth too. So don't have to worry about that one anymore either. Down here, the lespedezas doing great, taking over. These windmill palms that I potted up a few weeks ago, I had to set them up a little bit wonky so that the drips will get them. It's just because I'm going to be gone. I'm going to be out of town, so I want to make sure that the sprinklers will hit them. There are a lot of plants back here, and I think it would be asking a lot of somebody to hand water everything. So for now, this will work. They'll get hit by the drips, but it's a little weird having one sitting right next to that hydrangea tree and right there. Looks a little wonky. And these hydrangeas, these are the paniculata strawberry vanillas. These should be budding out here in a few weeks. There are a lot of mosquitoes over here, so if you see me wave my hand around, I'm just batting bugs away from my face. Yeah, I'm excited for those to flower over here. This is the honeysuckle major wheeler, that is. One of my favorites, but I am constantly having to pull it out. I'd like to put an arbor over here, up and above these steps. The problem is, it's about 8.5 feet from side to side, and I haven't found an arbor that's affordable, really, to put here. They're like a couple thousand dollars when you get them that wide, so I may have to build something myself, which would be worth it. I can do that. It's just going to take a little bit of time and planning. Creeping Jenny, creeping, being a creeper, doing its thing, taking over. Those are actually ones from last year. I'm going to put these begonias, the canary begonias. What are they? Yeah, canary wing begonias. They have a lighter foliage on them, kind of a chartreuse green, and I think that that'll look nicer because there's a little bit more shade here. It'll kind of illuminate the area. Plumeria's thrown out a lot of new foliage since I brought it out. It's looking great. It was a little bit mad at first because it got a lot of spray on it because there were some mealybugs on it, but recovering very nicely. And the Thai constellation, my Monstera deliciosa, doing well too. I'm going to be moving that in not too terribly long. Once the angle of the sun changes, it's going to be going on the other side of the patio. But for now, it's in deep, deep, deep shade. Very happy, just loving life. Living its best life. Oh, lost a branch on the mimosa. I've never lost a branch on this before. Anything that's come off there, I had to prune myself. I am hoping this will bloom this year. I can't remember if I pruned it back last year or not. They tend to only bloom on old wood, so hopefully it'll flower, because it's one of the things that's so great about a mimosa. But if I did give it a heavy prune last year, then that won't be happening. I can't remember if I did or not. Every few years, I have to give it a pretty heavy prune because it comes up and over the pool, and they are messy trees. Like, very, very, very messy trees, at least mine is. I can see I need to fix the top of the canopy on that thing, too. But, yeah, so it's possible I gave that a prune. I don't like it to come out and over the water, so we'll see. Time will tell. Everything over here is freshly planted, everything under the queen palm. I'm not super attached to how I did this. I might be redoing it. There's still a lot of cleaning up to do, so don't worry about that. Like I said, I'm going to be boarding a plane here in like an hour and a half, so this was all very last minute. I just did it. I haven't even had a chance to mulch anything in. I wanted to do more right here, but it is just solid roots, so I was only able to tuck in some little plants. I might end up pulling the roias. I put a roya here, a roya there, and then a cecressa right there, cecressa pileta, the purple heart plant, wondering you. Maybe might be switching that out with verbena. I'm not positive. We will see. I'll wait until I get home to figure that one out. I wanted to go pink sun impatient, orange sun impatient, pink sun impatient, but I couldn't dig a hole big enough over here to get another sun impatient in. So I got a pink one on each side, and then a Hemelia patens, which is the fireworks plant. One on each side there. Those will come up a little bit behind those, and they have orange flowers on them, so that will be pretty, but it's going to be like orange and then pink, orange and then pink. I would like for that to be broken up a little bit in the middle. So maybe what is it? What's her name? The Supervena Peachy Keen, and I have some of those. I don't have time to do that right now. So yeah, the Croton, all those annuals, Supertunia, Vista Bubblegum. I wanted to throw some of those in the ground for a really long time. So I'm thinking that might look cool. I didn't want them too close to these guys because they will choke them out again. Sorry about the mess. I'm just, everything is so chaotic right now. But that's why I wanted to do this, because it'll be a nice big contrast between now and July. Then over here, I planted two of the colocasia Thai giants. And it's actually leucocasia now, because they've decided that it's not really a colocasia, it's not really an alocasia, so it's leucocasia Thai giant. I plant them up a little bit higher. When I plant these, I just kind of barely manipulate their roots a little bit, and I try and plant them up just a smidge higher than the ground, because the last several years I've noticed them rotting a little bit, which never used to be a thing. So I don't know if it's something that's changed with the stock that they're making these from or what's going on there, but so I've been planting them a little bit higher and I've been having better success with them that way. And then back here, this is an alocasia wentii, I think. I can't remember. It was overwintered in the garage, and so was this one. This one, I overwintered dormant, so it still has to come back to life and do its thing. That one I kept growing. I just watered it and let it do its thing, and it did fantastic. So I was just sort of an experiment to see the difference in how they would grow. And I mean, it was well worth it. I barely had to water it, and this one back here just did great. So this upcoming winter, I'll probably do the same with this instead of letting it go dormant. I'll just let it keep growing because the other one was fine with it. It was really easy. And I also tucked in another Thai giant right here as well, right underneath the bananas. There's some gingers coming up. The gingers still have a long way to go, but that'll be pretty having a Thai giant here, and then there'll be big Thai giant leaves right there and right there. The alocasia that's back here, that the one I'm calling the wentii alocasia, it should stay high enough that it won't be blocked by the Thai giants, but we will see. Thai giants, they get really wide. I mean, they get tall, but I think that these alocasias should stay taller. They're taller than me. They're probably about 6.5 feet high. Well, that one is, and it's planted uphill a little bit. I need to remember to hose this tarp off and clean that table off before I go. Just remembered that. Glad I saw it. What are you guys doing? Hey, Tucker, don't eat dirt. Why are you nasty? It's that Espoma biotone. They love digging into that stuff. Pineapple lilies right here, doing great. They're not budding out yet, which is totally normal. They will be soon. This is another pineapple lily back here that I haven't had a chance to plant yet. This one I actually dug up from under my old queen palm, and I just threw some mulch in it to keep it alive. This right here, though, it is just one giant bulb from 1 year. I mean, it's huge. Then over here is a spider lily that I had dormant, and that's where it is for now. It's not where it's staying. It's just that way they stay moist and I don't have to worry about them. And yeah, like I said, I'm thinking when I get back in town, I'm going to be lifting and moving, at least scooting these bikini teenies back, because I don't want 3 foot tall plants right in the front of my garden. It just looks odd. Doesn't make sense. And I prefer to have a little small row of impatiens or something in the front for some color. These should be back there, but they kind of go wherever they want to. This banana's doing great, looking big and beautiful. And this planter from a few weeks ago is also doing well. I scooted it out so it'd get a little bit more sun. I knew that that might be kind of an issue with the wave petunias. I figured once they start to come over the front, they would get enough, but the Iconia begonia is shading them a little bit too much. And it's only been a couple days since I scooted it, and they're already responding really well, so that's good. There's like 70 caladium bulbs in there. That was in last weekend's vlog. everything over here is just set up so that the sprinklers will hit them. So it'll be gone, which I've said multiple times by now. I also moved the table over so the umbrella's kind of shading this area of the other plants that I still need to get working with, and lots of fun videos and projects coming up. And that's what the majority of these things are for. My little cactus and succulent area needs to be weeded. I'm really bad about weeding this area because, you know, cactus and whatnot, and you get stabbed. The prickly pears, it's those little glockets, those little white hair-like needles. I hate them, and I just need to really just wear disposable gloves, really, is all I'm worried about. The big spines don't bother me. But yes, I need to weed that out. That's not happening right now because, like I said, I'm boarding a plane here in like 2 hours. But they'll be okay down here. There's not going to be much change here because, like I said, I just finished doing this area. This area I finished doing like maybe 2 hours ago. So, I mean, well, that's more the impatience. This is from like a day or so ago. Those begonias will fill in. The hydrangeas will start blooming. That's going to look really pretty when everything starts taking off. Have some more impatience over there. Drifted them up here. I haven't decided what I'm going to pot up in this planter yet. Excuse you, doves. I wanted to put like my Mediterranean fan palm in here with some geraniums or something, but the teenagers around here like to steal things, especially if they can pick them up and lift them. So I don't want to put anything in here that I wouldn't be okay, or I'm not okay with, but you know what I mean. I would prefer just to use cheap annuals in there. I don't want to put anything in there that I'd be super upset about them taking, because little brats sometimes. All these little weedy looking greeny things in here, those are impatiens that have reseeded from last year. So I decided to give that that was on last weekend's vlog. So I don't know if you guys care to hear that. And this was just planted up, so there's not going to be much of a change there. But there will be between this tour and next month's tour. So wanted to do that now in case there are people who just watch the tours and not the vlogs. You know what I'm saying? I'll get this mulched in. I'm still waiting to do that because this tree needs to be cut down. The Japanese maple that died, it's gone. So that will have to wait a week or so. I just didn't see reason to mulch this and then have this big bare area over here. And then there are all these impatient seedlings coming up. So it's like, I'm going to be gone for a week. I'll let them do their thing. They're on the drip. See how big they get in a week. And if they haven't done much, then I'll go ahead and mulch over them. We'll see what happens. And then the hanging baskets, which were just done. This video for these will hopefully have been out last week. It depends on how much editing I do while I'm out of town on vacation. We will see. Same thing with these porch planters. These look really cool from the street. And they've actually done a lot of growing just in like the last few days. Those lobelia have really taken off. They're doing great. The alocasia fridex is kind of chilling. Same thing with the cordylins. But the spider plants, the impatiens, the lobelias, they're doing really well. The bananas are too. I didn't cut back the Iconia begonias like I should have. Maybe I should do that before I go. I just keep forgetting to do it. So I should probably get on that. I'm not sure. Also, I, with these planters, didn't realize until I was done with them that I have two different bacopas in them. This one, it's called like Blue Eyes or something like that bacopa. Hold on, let me correct myself. This one is a blue bacopa from Proven Winners that I didn't realize I had. Well, more of a purple bacopa. Can't remember its name. If I can remember it, then I will put it in here. And it's really pretty. It's almost luminous, which I think is gorgeous. Whereas this one right here, this is what I did in the video. I didn't plant them both up in the video because it seemed kind of redundant. I just did one of them. And I was like, I'm going to do that times two. But this one, I really need to cut that Iconia begonia back. And the begonia looks, or not the begonia, this bacopa, I'm sorry. This bacopa looks almost identical to the other one. A little bit more unruly, but the flowers really, really do look very similar, don't they? But totally different shape to them. I guess on camera they look a little bit more pink. So I don't know. So they have two different bacopas in them. So it'll be interesting to see how those do and the difference between them. I'm going to try and remember to cut those Iconia begonias back before I leave. These are on drip, so while I'm gone, nobody has to water them. And that's the same thing with these urn planters here. I still need to replant the boots that I do every year. But yeah, this one's doing really well too. The lobelia are looking nice. I'm excited for those to come over the front a little bit further because they add such a nice pop of color. Like an excellent pop of color. See them down there? They're so cute. And I'm thinking about maybe putting a larger planter behind this one, something tall and narrow. I haven't decided yet. That'll be like in a whole different thing if I like spruce up the front porch a little bit more. Hey, Tobes, you're such a good boy. have some shrubs and things over here I need to plant too. Where are you going? You don't go past the line. Yeah, there's still some shrubs and things to plant, but otherwise... Well, otherwise what? What was I going to say? I don't even know. Yeah, I'll have to do a little bit of editing. That's okay. Just a very last minute quasi-garden tour, because a lot of the plants around here are placed for irrigation, not where they're going to go, so they'll stay watered, and I won't have to worry about them while I'm out of town, then when I come home, can get to planting, which is going to be a lot of fun. Okay, the gingers are coming up nicely. I know I need to send someone one of these, so I need to get in here and dig a rhizome up, and I'm going to wait until I get home. Probably just ship that out there fresh. That would do better that way. Oh, I almost forgot. Here's the pitcher plant planter I put together probably a month and a half ago. The carnivorous plants, the sarracenias that are in here, are doing very, very well. Very happy, very low maintenance, just doing their thing. And this is green water I'm using in my fish tank, kind of growing algae water. Ostrich ferns, I mentioned when it gets hot, they start to burn back a little bit. And I think that's everything. Everything that I would want to see or be able to show the change from month to month over here. So, I know, it was very fast, kind of crazy and chaotic, but one, welcome to my channel, and like I said, I gotta get ready and go hop on a plane. So the next video, the next vlog after this one will probably be a vacation vlog, depending on how much filming I end up doing while I'm gone. Like I mentioned before, I'm really excited to, one, just go on vacation, because that's fun, good quality time and relaxing time. Two, to go to different nurseries and things while I'm down south. That's always fun too, and do some plant shopping. And three, it's always fun to be gone for a week, come home, and see what your plants have done. So that's one of the other things. I don't know. I've done too much today. Planted up my front yard, moved all my plants off the patio, planted up that. It's just, I'm tired. I'm actually not tired. I will be very soon. I'll sleep on the plane. And then any updates or anything like that, I'll be sure to post those on my social media, which is all linked down in the description. I'm on Instagram way more than anything else. Follow me and I'll follow you back. It's a lot of fun looking at everybody's pictures and me and plant nerds together. And don't forget to leave the video a thumbs up. It helps a ton, helps the channel a lot, helps the videos. It means a lot to me, so thank you. And subscribe as well and hit that notification bell. I upload multiple times a week, and that way you'll know when new videos come out. All right, hope everybody's doing well, having a great day, great life. Everything's just going beautifully for you. Oh, that's a sad leaf. And as always, and most importantly, everybody, keep on growing. Bye-bye.